Hawaiian night tonight. And I want to thank Renee Hibbert right now because we can't do anything without Renee. Would you thank her right now?
I'd also like to thank Jack Peterson. We couldn't do it if you couldn't hear anything. So if you hear anything, we thank Jack. Thank you, Jack and Landon. And another quick thanks to Anson George, Sean Patrick for lights and sound, and of course, our Ryan Olson Teacher of the Year with his great camera. Thank you. And the real stars are on the show waiting for you. I thank you for all your kids. They've been lots of fun to do this. Thanks.
A fiddler on the roof. Sounds great, you know. But here in our little town, Benetevka, you might say, every one of us is a fiddler on the roof, trying to scratch out a simple, pleasant tune without breaking his neck. You may ask, why do we stay up here if it is so dangerous? We stay because Benetevka is our home. And how do we keep our balance? That I can tell you in one word, tradition.
Tradition, 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 tradition.
And because of these traditions, we've kept our balance for many, many years. We have traditions for everything. How to eat, how to sleep, how to wear clothes, or anything. We always keep our heads covered, and we always wear them in the prayer shawl. This shows our constant devotion to God. You may ask, how did these traditions start? I'll tell you. I don't know. But it's a tradition, and because of these traditions, every man knows who he is and what God expects.
wife and children say his daily prayers, and who has the right as master of the house to have the final word at home? The papa! The papas, the papas. Tradition.
Move us all the way to make a proper home, a quiet home, a kosher home. We must raise a family and run the home. So papas free to read the holy book.
The mama.
Tradition!
of these traditions. Without these traditions, you get shaky as a fiddler on the roof.
Put them on my head, by the stove, foolish girl. Where's Hava?
She's out in the barn milking. When will Papa be home?
Oh, it's almost the Sabbath, and he worries me a lot when he'll be home. All day long, riding on top of his wagon like a prince.
Mommy, you know Papa works hard.
His horse works harder, and you don't have to defend your Papa to me. I know him a little longer than you. He could drive a person crazy. He should only live and be well. Spritza, get me some more potatoes.
Yes, Mama.
You were reading again? Why does a girl have to read?
Sorry, Mama. Mama, Yenta's coming. She's down the road.
I wonder if Yenta finally found a husband for you, Saitel.
I'm not anxious for Yenta to find me a husband.
Well, finish what you're doing in the barn. I want to talk to Yenta alone.
Mama, may I go outside and play, please?
You have feet? Go!
Can I go too?
Go too.
But Mama, the men she finds! The last one was so old, he was bald! He had no hair!
A poor girl without a dowry can't be so particular. You want a hair? Marry a monkey!
But even a poor girl without a dowry has to look at her husband sometimes.
A husband isn't to look at, a husband is to get.
But Mama, I'm not yet 20 and—
Shut! Do you want to tempt evil eye? Do you have to boast about your age? Do you want to tempt evil eye? No, go inside, hurry, get ready for the Sabbath.
Golden, golden darling, I had to see you because I had such news for you, and not just every day in the week news, once in a lifetime news.
Where are your daughters? Outside?
No, good. Such diamonds, such jewels. I'll find every one of them a husband. Just wait and see, Golda. But you shouldn't be so picky, because even the worst husband, heaven forbid, is better than no husband, heaven forbid. And you should know better than me. Ever since my Aaron died, I've been a poor widow. All alone, no one to talk to. All I do at night is think of him. And even thinking of him gives me no pleasure, because you know as well as I, Goldie, that he was not much of a man. He never made a living. Everything he touched turned to mud. But better than nothing.
Is Seidel in the house?
Yes, but she's busy. You can come back later.
But there's something I'd like to tell her.
I said later.
Later.
What does that poor skinny tailor want with Seidel?
Oh, they've been friends since they were babies. They talk, they play.
They play? What do they play?
I don't know. They're just children.
From such children come other children.
Mato, he's nothing. Yenta, you said.
Oh, children, children. May they be the blessing in your old age. My Aaron, may he rest in peace, can never give me children. But what's the use complaining? Other women enjoy complaining, but not Yenta. Not every woman in the world is a Yenta. Well, I must go, Goldie, to prepare my poor Sabbath table. It was a pleasure talking our hearts out to each other.
But Yenta, you said!
Ay, I'm losing my head. One day, it will fall off altogether, and the horse will kick it in the mud, and goodbye, Yenta. It's about Laser Wolf, the butcher. He's been a widower all these years. It's lonely, you understand. Well, he cast his eye on your Seidel.
My Seidel?
No, the Tsar's Seidel. Of course, your Seidel.
Such a match for my Seidel. But Tevye wants a learned man. He doesn't like Laser.
Good. So So Debbie won't marry Laser. Laser wants the daughter, not the father. Listen to me, Golder. Send Tevye to Laser. Let Laser discuss it himself. He's a good man and a wealthy one, no? Yes. He'll win Tevye over. Well, you don't have to thank me, Goldie, because besides for my fee, which Laser will cover anyway, gives me satisfaction to make people happy. And what better satisfaction is there? So goodbye, Goldie. And
goodbye, Yantum.
What did Yenta want, Mama?
When I want you to know, I'll tell you. Now go, hurry. Get ready for the Sabbath.
I wonder if Yenta finally found a match for you, Sigel.
I'm not anxious for Yenta to find me a husband.
Not unless it's Model the Tailor.
I didn't ask you.
Sigel, you're the oldest. They have to make a match for you before they can make one for me.
And then one for me.
So if Yenta...
Yenta!
Well, somebody has to arrange the matches. Young people can't decide these things for themselves.
She might bring someone wonderful.
Someone interesting.
And well off.
And important.
Take your time. This man that I
enough you pick on me, Reb Tevye, blessed me with 5 daughters and a life of poverty. But what have you got against my horse? Sometimes I think when things get a little too quiet up there, you say to yourself, let's see what kind of mischief I can play on my friend Ted.
Aha! So you're finally here, my breadwinner.
I'll talk to you later.
So why are you late today? Where's your horse?
Oh, he had a little problem with his leg.
Well, hurry up. The sun won't wait for you. I have something to say to you.
I still have some deliveries in the village.
You'll be late for the Sabbath.
I won't be late.
You'll be late.
I won't be late. If you ever stop talking, I won't be late.
You can die from such a man.
As the good book says, heal us, O Lord, and we shall be healed. In other words, send us a cure, for we have the sickness already. I'm not really complaining. After all, thanks to you, I'm starving to death. So you made many, many poor people. I realize, of course, it's no shame to be poor, but it's no great honor either. What would have been so terrible if I did have a small fortune? If I were a rich man, give a dim 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 a all day long I'd bitty bitty bum. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. Dim a 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 dim. If I were a bitty bitty rich, I'd little diddle diddle man. I'd build a bricked off house with rooms by the dozen right in the middle of the town. A fine tin roof with real wooden floors below. There would be one long staircase just going up and one even longer coming down. And one more leading nowhere just for show. If I my yard with chicks and turkeys and geese and ducks for the town to see and hear, squawking just as noisily as they can, and each loud kill of a kill of a cow of a cat will land like a trumpet on the ear, as if to say, here lives a wealthy man. If I were a rich man, give a dim a dim a dim a dim a dim a dim a dim. All day long I'd bitty bitty bum. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. Dim a 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 dim. If I were a bitty bitty rich, I'd a diddle 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 man. I'd see my wife, my gold, looking like a rich man's wife with a profitable chin, supervising meals to her heart's delight. I'd see her putting on airs and strutting like a peacock. Oh, what a happy one she did. Screaming at the servants day and night, put your head, put your head. The most important men in town will come to fawn on me. They will ask me to advise them like a Solomon the Wise. If you please, Reb Tevye, pardon me, Reb Tevye, posing problems that would cross a rabbi's eyes. Yabba da da da, yabba da da da. And it won't make one bit of difference if I am. answer right or wrong. When you're rich, they think you really know. If I were rich, I'd have the time that I like to sit in the synagogue and pray, and maybe have a seat by the eastern wall. And I'd discuss the holy books with the learned men 7 hours every day, and that would be the sweetest thing of all. If I were a rich man, all day long I'd pity, pity, bum. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. Lord, who made the light and the lamp, you decreed I should be what I am. Would it spoil some vast eternal plan? If I were a wealthy man,
you forgot more of the Sabbath.
Oh, this is dirt news than the plague in Odessa.
Oh, you got news. Terrible news in the outside world. Terrible.
What is it?
What does it say? In a little village called Brzozowka, all the Jews were evicted, forced to leave their home. For what reason? It doesn't say. Maybe the Tsar overtook their land. Maybe a plague.
Hey, the Tsar hath his own personal plague.
Amen. Ah, Brum, why don't you ever bring us any good news?
I only read it. It's to eat it from the authorities.
May the authorities grow like onions, with their heads in the ground. Amen.
Why do you curse them? What good does your cursing do? You stand around and curse and chatter, and don't do anything. You'll all chatter your way into the grave.
Excuse me, but you're not from around here.
No?
Then where are you from?
Kiev. I was a student in the university there.
Aha! The university. Is that where they teach you to disrespect your elders?
That is where I learned there is more to life than talk. You ought to know what is happening in the outside world.
Why should I break my head about the outside world? Let them break their own heads.
As the good book says, if you spit in the air, it lands in your face.
That's nonsense. You can't close your eyes to what's happening in the world.
He is right.
He's right and he's right. How can they both be right?
You know, you're also right.
He's right. He's too young to be right.
Good Sabbath. Good Sabbath.
Good Sabbath. The rabbi's order.
Oh, of course. So, you're from Kiev, Reb.
Perchik.
As Moses, as King David put it, I am a stranger in a strange land.
Moses said that.
Forgive me. As Abraham put it, I'm